charge a few times.
Machine guns are the backbone of any military's firepower, unleashing a torrent of bullets that can turn the tide of battle. These formidable weapons are built for power, precision, and reliability, capable of mowing down enemy forces, disabling vehicles, and shattering fortified positions. With their thunderous roar and relentless fire, they instill fear in adversaries and provide unmatched support to ground troops. The machine guns in the US military's inventory have proven themselves in numerous conflicts, from D-Day to Afghanistan, earning legendary status. These formidable weapons have consistently demonstrated their effectiveness and reliability, cementing their place as iconic tools of warfare across decades of military engagements.
All right, close the cover. All right, so you're in the full load now.
Meet the Browning M2HB, or Maduce, as it's sometimes colloquially known. The HB stands for heavy barrel. Well, because it has a heavy barrel. This amazing gun really is testament to John Browning's genius in firearms design. Internally, this gun is almost a copy of the Browning .30 caliber. The original guns that Browning built as .50 caliber guns were water-cooled, just like the original .30 caliber guns. The water-cooled version was designated the M1921 .50 caliber machine gun. The US Air Service initially was interested in this for mounting on aircraft. But early aircraft were frankly a bit too fragile to deal with the recoil and the muzzle blast from this gun. Dr. Samuel Green, who was a Springfield engineer assigned to Colt, made a couple of really important changes and developments to the gun. One of them is the iconic charging handle. The original M1921 just had a charging handle sticking straight out the side, so the developers gave it the cammed charging handle, which was a significant improvement. Dr. Green came up with a design for the internal components that allows the charging handle to be easily changed between left and right hand feed without needing much in the way of replacement parts. By 1933, the gun was redesignated as the Browning M2. When this was first developed for World War I, it was intended to be an anti-tank gun and also an anti-aircraft gun. However, by World War II, it was not really an effective anti-tank gun anymore. But also in World War II, it became an ideal aircraft armament. Not anti-aircraft, but in the aircraft. The US had fighters with 6 or 8 .50 caliber M2s mounted on their wings as primary armament. And that allowed what was by that point an obsolete anti-tank weapon to stay in service. By the time we get to the 1950s, the .50 caliber became obsolete as an aircraft weapon since it is not powerful enough. So, it kind of transitioned into being a general-purpose, vehicular-mounted gun. And that's where we still see it in service today. It is a tremendously long-serving, venerable, and incredibly effective firearm. The M2 has been used by the United States in almost all its conflicts since its production. The machine gun is almost 61.42 inches in length and weighs 84 pounds alone, and 128 pounds with its tripod. The bore has a diameter of 0.50 inches, obviously. The M2 Browning has an effective firing range of 1,800 meters and a maximum range of 6,800 meters. The fired bullet has a muzzle velocity of 809 miles per second. The M2HB variant, manufactured by General Dynamics, has a cyclic rate of 450 to 600 rounds per minute. Faster variants include the AMM3 for use in aircraft, having a rate of fire around 1,200 rounds per minute. One belt of the M2HB comes with 100 rounds. If you were to take a 2-meter hole within a bunker using an M2 Browning, you would need 300 rounds. That's $1,500 at $5 per round. A lot of the US military inventories are being upgraded to the M2A1. Due to the long procedure for changing the barrel, an improved system was developed called QCB, or Quick Change Barrel. A lightweight version, weighing 24 pounds less, a mere 60 pounds, was also developed. Since these guns don't really tend to wear out to the point that they can't just be repaired and put back in service, it's not cost-effective to replace them with anything brand new. So, 100 years after its adoption by the US military, Madius is still very much alive and kicking. Now, let's check out something, lighter to carry around. Are you familiar with M60, aka the Pig, the machine gun choice of John Rambo? Well, this is the machine gun that replaced that legendary weapon. As a formidable component of the lighter 5.56mm based M249, M16 and M4 weapons, M240 is a successful and well-regarded tool of destruction that has proven itself in battle in Afghanistan, Iraq and now in Ukraine. With a rate of fire of up to 950 rounds per minute, this weapon can throw out a wall of lead and wreak havoc on those on the receiving end. The 7.62mm rounds that this weapon shoots are highly regarded for their great stopping power and high penetration in urban combat situations. And it has a great combat report, as the 100% of soldiers using it are confident in this weapon. The M240 is a US-built version of the Belgian FN-MAG that is one of the most widespread and effective general-purpose machine guns in the world. MAG had several design attributes of the World War II-era German MG42, including its trigger mechanisms, quick-change barrel, and spring-loaded dust cover. But much of the weapon was derived from the basic design formula of the Browning Model 1918 BAR. Since its introduction in 1957, the FN-MAG has dominated the market for Western Bloc machine guns. Despite the DNA it shares with the venerable BAR, this weapon was originally rejected in favor of the US-made M60. Ironically, two decades after, the M60 was replaced by a US-built version of the MAG, designated as the M240. Although M240 entered the US Army in 1977 as a coaxial tank gun, it slowly found more applications in the 1980s and 1990s, as it has also been adopted by the US Navy, Marine Corps, and Coast Guard. While possessing many of the same basic characteristics as its predecessor, the durability of the M240 results in superior reliability when compared to the M60. The M240 actually has a more complex gas system than the M60, but gives better reliability combined with lower maintenance requirements. The rate of fire can be adjusted using three different gas regulator settings. The first setting enables the weapon to fire at 650 to 750 rounds per minute. The second setting at 750 to 850 rounds per minute. And the third setting at 850 to 950 rounds per minute. To change these settings, you need to disassemble the barrel, remove the gas regulator collar, and rotate the gas regulator to control the amount of gas passing through the system. However, the firing rate is adjusted only when fouling causes sluggish operation of the weapon, and there is no time to clean the weapon properly. Several sources report that the M240 is the most reliable machine gun in the world. During testing in the 1990s, it was able to fire an astonishing 26,000 rounds between failures. This reliability was further confirmed in a 2013 torture test of the M240B, after which there was no loss of accuracy, despite the weapon firing a total of 15,000 rounds at its cyclical rate of fire. By the end of that 2013 test, it had fired more than 32,000 rounds without failures. The effective range of the M240 is with a bipod, 880 yards, and with a tripod, 1,980 yards. The weapon has a maximum range of 4,074 yards. Its 7.62mm rounds, high penetration and stopping ability are favored by the soldiers. Throughout the years, the US M240 machine guns have been improved and upgraded by installing various upgrade kits. As of March 2022, the United States Army has a solicitation ongoing for an M240 machine gun 6.8 by 51 mm conversion kit to modify the 7.62 by 51 mm NATO chambered M240B and M240L general purpose machine guns to fire the 6.8 by 51 mm ammunition. This concludes our episode that provides a glimpse into the M2 and M240 heavy machine guns. So, what do you think about these formidable weapons? How effective are they? What other pieces of military hardware would you like us to cover in our future episodes? Also, if you were lucky enough to shoot one of the weapons mentioned in this video, please comment. Remember to hit the subscribe button and ring that bell to stay updated with our latest content. And while you're here, why not check out another one of our exciting videos? Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.